Now that generative AI has arrived, organizations are looking forward for the best ways to implement and scale these new technologies while maintaining reliable performance and keeping costs in check. So that's why the Azure OpenAI Service offers different deployment options so that organizations can choose the right one for their specific needs. On this episode of the Azure Essentials Show, we will be exploring these deployment types and walk through a series of demos to show you how to optimize them with the Azure best practices. So stick around. Welcome back to the Azure Essentials Show. I'm Thomas, and I'm here with David, a principal program manager here at Microsoft. Today, we're going to talk about the Azure OpenAI Service deployments, especially provisioned deployments and how customers can get started with them. Thanks, David, for joining us.
Excited to be here, Thomas. Thanks for having me.
So David, can you start by explaining the different deployment options we have?
Absolutely. There are two ways to deploy Azure OpenAI Service, standard and provisioned. The standard model is pay-as-you-go and charges users based on the number of tokens processed. This flexible pricing is ideal for low to medium volume workloads with fluctuating demands. For example, projects that are still in the development and testing phases. Provisioned deployments, on the other hand, are charged based on your capacity requirements. They are optimized for high volume production workloads where you have more predictable demand and need consistent performance. These are purchased in quantities of provisioned throughput units, or PTUs for short.
So, okay, that's interesting. So what are these PTUs exactly?
You can think of PTUs as reserved blocks of processing capacity the customers can purchase. They're a way to allocate a specific amount of throughput for your deployment. This gives you reliable processing capacity, minimal latency, and a predictable cost structure, all of which are essential for implementing enterprise-level AI.
Fantastic. So I got it. So PTUs ensure low latency and stable performance, even during these peak times. So let's say a customer wants to use provisioned deployments. How do they get started with this?
So assuming you have a production workload that you want to use, the first step is to estimate how many PTUs you'll need for your application. We've created a capacity calculator in Azure OpenAI Studio to forecast your PTU usage based on your specific workload details. Let's take a look at how the calculator works. So in Azure OpenAI Studio, you first go to Quota, and then to Azure OpenAI Provisioned, and then Capacity Calculator. Here you can see the capacity calculator where for a particular selected model and a set of workloads, it shows you how many PTUs are required. So for example, if we want to use GPT-4o with a chatbot that we're creating, I can just fill in the details here. Chat, 20 calls a minute, 2,000 input tokens, let's say 1,000 output tokens. When I click calculate, you can see that this requires 50 PTUs in order to run.
Awesome. So you now have estimated your PTU usage, then what?
So the next step would be to ensure that you have the quota available in the region where you want to be able to deploy this. So to check that, we can close the capacity calculator. And on the quota page here, you can see that for provision managed throughput units, or PTUs, I right now have 1,000 available and zero used in Poland Central, which is the region where I plan to create my deployment. So at this point in time, I have plenty of quota available for me to attempt to create my deployment. If for some reason I didn't have enough quota available, I could click Request Quota and fill out a form to request more quota, which will be processed in about 2 business days.
Fantastic. So after confirming the quota, what is next?
So the next step would be to actually create the provision deployment itself. To do that, we go to the Deployments tab. And here we click Deploy Model, Deploy Base Model, and we choose from the model catalog the model we want to deploy. And so previously we said GPT-4o, we'll confirm that. And then on the deployment dialog, which if you've already deployed standard deployments for Azure OpenAI, you might be very familiar with this. The important difference is that you want to select for the deployment type provisioned managed. This is what tells us to create a provisioned deployment instead of a standard token-based deployment. then I can set my deployment name, version, and most importantly, how many PTUs I want to use for this model. In this case, we want to use 50 PTUs. So that's set to where I want it. I'm going to click confirm pricing. And this is a dialog that tells you how much you'll be charged for the PTUs. By default, you'll be charged an hourly price, in this case, $100 per hour. And it tells you that you could purchase an Azure reservation to get a further discount. I can confirm my understanding of the rates, click deploy, and now I have my deployment created.
Awesome. So while you're doing this, you were also mentioning reservations. So what is the difference between PTUs hourly and reservations here?
Sure. By default, PTUs are charged on an hourly basis for as long as the deployment is running. The hourly billing is great if you need to create a deployment for a day or two, maybe to run a benchmark, for example. But anything longer than that can get quite expensive for many customers. As a result, we also offer 1 month and 1 year term discounts on PTUs through the purchase of an Azure reservation. Reservations offer significant discounts, and most customers will get the best ROI by purchasing one.
Yeah, I think Azure reservations are always a great way to cut down on costs and keep those things on a good level. So I see, do these reservations reserve or guarantee these PTU capacities?
Yeah, that's a great question because the name Azure reservation can be a little confusing. Reservations themselves do not reserve or guarantee the PTU capacity for you. They're purely a method to achieve a billing discount. It's important for our customers to know that capacity for provisioned is dynamic and can sell out in some regions. And capacity is allocated at deployment time, not reservation purchase time. So as a result, the best practice is to always create your deployments first, then purchase a reservation. This will prevent you from purchasing a term commitment for PTUs that you may not be able to use in the way that you planned.
Got it. And how do you purchase provisioned reservations?
Purchasing reservations follows the standard Azure model. Let's take a look. To get to the reservation portal, in Azure OpenAI Studio, I can go back to the quota tab and then click purchase a reservation with this button right here. When I click this, this will take me out of Azure OpenAI Studio and to the Azure portal. Remember, reservations are a standard Azure offering and not Azure OpenAI specific. And so there's a specific place in the Azure portal in order to purchase them. Now to purchase the reservations, there's two steps. You need to specify the type of the reservation and then the number of PTUs you want to purchase. When I say the type of reservation, part of that is the scope, which indicates what part of your Azure resources do you want to have covered by the reservation. So I can cover deployments from a single resource group all the way through an entire billing account. So I'll leave it an entire billing account since that covers the greatest greatest scope. And now I pick the term for my commitment. Now notice I have some recommendations down here. That's because before I started this demo today, I had some deployments already running in both Australia East and Poland Central. Let's just go ahead and purchase a reservation for all of those deployments. So in Poland Central here, you can see there are 1 month and 1 year terms for reservations. And for a 1 year term, you can either pay upfront as one monthly charge, or you can pay on a per month basis. In this case, let's pick per month. Click add to cart and now view cart. And here we can see where we specify the auto renewal policy, the name of it, if I want to give it a name that I can remember, and the quantity. So 400 was what was recommended. We just added a 50 PTU deployment. So I'm going to change this to 450. Now to complete the purchase, I'll click review and buy. Here's some information. I can confirm it. I'm going to click buy now. And in a moment here, we'll get a confirmation screen that comes up. A couple of things to to note is that once you create your reservation, you'll want to monitor its usage to maximize your cost savings. One way to do this is through the Azure Monitor. The other way is by going to the reservation portal. We have resources that walk you through both of these options. You can find these links in the episode description.
Awesome. That's excellent. So customers have a lot of control getting most out of their reservation usage. So David, any final tips for our viewers?
Yes, please remember to create your deployments before your reservations to ensure you get the capacity you need. And double check that you purchase a reservation in the same region where you created your deployment. There are limits on canceling reservations, and each reservation only covers a single region.
Fantastic. So there's obviously some great stuff we talked about today. And if people want to learn more, where can they find more information about this?
Yeah. For anyone looking to build skills you need to leverage PTUs effectively, Microsoft has a new training module on Microsoft Learn all about provision deployments. Plus, we've got more resources for you to learn about deployment options, including a blog post that covers all of today's topics in more detail.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining us, David.
My pleasure, Thomas. Thanks for having me.
Check out the episode description below to find the links to the training module and all the other resources. If you have questions or comments, you can add them below, and we will make sure that we come back to you. If you liked today's episode, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when a new episode drops. Until next time, thanks for watching the Azure Essentials Show.